Hello and welcome to my channel. This free-falling photo frame slideshow is what we are going to create today. Let's see how to create this using After Effects. Before further proceeding, I would like to thank you for supporting me. If you are new to this channel, please do consider subscribing. That would be highly appreciated. Please don't skip the video. Please do watch the video completely. Let's not waste any more of the time. Let's get started. I have imported 6 stock image files from the website Pexels, and also I have imported a background file to create this awesome stunning slideshow. Create a new composition. Name it as background placeholder. I am choosing a 1920 by 1080 composition with the frame rate of 30 and a duration of 10 seconds. And bring in your background file into the timeline. Search for curves effect and apply it into the image file and change the curves as you wish. Feel free to choose your own background file. Also apply the tint effect. Scale and position the background file as you wish. Create a new adjustment layer and name it as vignette. Search for CC vignette effect and apply it into the layer. Adjust the amount and angle of view as per your choice. Create a new composition, name it as photo frame and set the width and height to 600 and 700. Select the rectangle tool and set the fill to none and stroke to solid color. Set the stroke width to 20 and create a perfect square. Scale and position the square as to fit the composition edges. Select the rectangle tool and now set the fill to solid color and set the stroke to none and create a shape like this. Create another composition, name it as photo placeholder 1 and set the width and height to 600 and 700. Bring in the photo frame into the composition. Also bring in the first image file and position it as per your choice. Create another composition and name it as main. Set the width and height to 1920 by 1080. Bring in the background placeholder and the photo placeholder 1 into the timeline. Move up the photo placeholder 1 above the background placeholder. Duplicate the photo placeholder 1 composition as many as images you have. Open up the photo placeholder 2 and change the image. Position and scale the image to fit the composition. Do this for all the photo placeholder compositions. Bring in all the photo placeholder compositions into the main composition timeline. Place the photo placeholder 1 above all the compositions. Select all the photo placeholder compositions and make them as 3D layer. Position the photos as you like. Use the position and rotation properties to position the photos. Create a new camera. I am choosing a 35mm preset. Move the camera layer above all the layers. Open up the camera options and turn on the depth of field and set the blur level to 250%. Change the aperture and the focus distance so that only the first photo is in focus. Open up the transform properties and create keyframes for point of interest, position and orientation. Go to the 15 frame mark Using the camera tools, position the second photo. Make sure the second photo is in focus. Also create a keyframe for orientation. Go to around 2 seconds and change the orientation value slightly and copy the point of interest and position values at the 15 frame mark and paste it to the 2 second mark. Now RAM preview this. The animation is too slow, so I am bringing closer the keyframes. Go to the 2 second mark and position the third photo and make sure the third photo is in focus. Also create a keyframe for the orientation. Go to the 3 second mark and change the orientation value slightly. Copy the point of interest on the position values and paste it to the 3 second mark. Do this for all the other photos. Once you have finished keyframing all the photos, select all the keyframes and press F9 to ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Create a new null object and make it as a 3D layer. Parent the camera layer to the null one object. Press P to bring up the position property. Click on the stopwatch of the position property along with holding Alt key to write an expression. Write in the wiggle expression. Choose your own values. I am choosing 3,5. Create a new adjustment layer. Before that, turn on the motion blur, all the photo placeholder compositions. Search for 4 color gradient and apply it into the adjustment layer. And change the blending mode to add. Press T to bring up the opacity property and set it to 10%. Now RAM preview this. Yeah, that's good. That's it. Let's see the output once again. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post the videos. Click on the like button and share it with your friends. Comment down if you have anything to ask. And once again, thanks for being here and supporting me. This is Raudran signing off.